Hello friends, welcome back to Rare Tutor. Today we are testing Hanyuan Image 2.1 text-to-image model. Hanyuan Image 2.1 is a powerful 17 billion text-to-image model capable of generating stunning 2K resolution images. Its two-stage architecture combines a multimodal large language model and a character-aware encoder for improved text rendering, along with a refiner model that enhances clarity and reduces artifacts. Key features include high-quality cinematic generation, multilingual support in Chinese and English, a DIT-based advanced architecture, glyph-aware processing with BiTe5, flexible aspect ratios, and automatic prompt enhancement. For full details, please check the official link in the description. First, we will recreate this example image. I have added a group bypasser node. Please use one group at a time. Don't enable both groups at once. Here you can select GGUF or SafeTensor's model. It's really easy to switch between the models. I have selected Hanyuan Image 2.1 Q8 version 1 GGUF model. For all the links for models and workflow, please check in the video description. Dequant D-type is default. Patch D-type is default. Patch on device is false. Select the compute device as CUDA or any other device you are using. If you have a low VRAM, you can put required virtual RAM in gigabytes in this option. I am adding 10 GB as virtual RAM. Select donor device as CPU and high precision LoRa is true. Here select the clip model. First choose BiTe5 small model. As the DGGUF model of BiTe5 gave me an error, I am choosing SafeTensor model here. Next, select the Qwen 2.5 VL 7 billion GGUF model. Select type as Hanyuan image. Select the compute device as CUDA or any other device you are using. If you have a low VRAM, you can put required virtual RAM in gigabytes in this option. I am adding 10 GB as virtual RAM. And here select the BAE model. Here also you can choose BAE GGUF model or SafeTensor model. Here add your image resolution. I am adding a width and height of 2048 pixels. Here I have also given a note for best resolutions for Hanyuan Image 2.1. If you are using Sage Attention, select Auto option, or if you don't have Sage Attention, disable it. Here select True to enable FP16 accumulation option. If you don't want it, set it to False. First block cache node will increase the speed by reducing the steps, but too high a value will decrease the image quality. So I am adding only 0.10. Shift is 5. I have added the following prompt for image generation. Hyper-realistic and highly detailed scene. In a lush green forest, trees and vines naturally form the English characters, RT. The branches curve gracefully into the letter shapes, with small birds perched on them. Sunlight filters through the dense canopy of leaves, casting soft rays and a golden glow. The atmosphere is vibrant, natural, and full of life. Here is the negative prompt. Here is the magic happens. You may have tried many Hanyuan Image ComfUI workflows, but may felt the quality of the generated image is not so good, despite of using the FP8 models. This is the magical sampler generating the good quality images. I think this is the first video on entire web revealing this secret. I am saying this because, after a lot of testing and after generating 100 plus images, I found this. So if you like my work, please hit the like button so it will inspire me to do such experiments in the future. I have selected 30 steps, CFG is 3.5, sampler is DPM BB2S Ancestral, scheduler is beta and the denoise is 1. Okay, let's hit the run button. It took around 7 minutes. On my RTX 3060, I have enabled only 65% performance in my GPU. In 100% power, it even generates much faster. This image looks good. Let's generate another image with Q8 version 1 GGUF model. Okay, let's hit the run button. Now I am using Q8 version 2, let's check the quality. Rest all the settings are same as previous generation. Okay, let's hit the run button. I didn't find too much difference. Image looks slightly more better quality than version 1. Now I am using distilled Q8 version 2. Let's check the quality. Rest all the settings are same as previous generation. Let's generate another image in painterly style using distilled Q8 version 2. You can reduce the steps and use CFG1 in distilled Q8 model, but you need to test it to check which setting best suits for your GPU. Image generated in painterly style looks good, and painted texture also looks good. As I am using RTX 3000 series GPU, I suppose to use FP8 E5 N2 version. As of now, E5 N2 version not available, so I am testing using FP8 E4M and 3FN version. Rest all the settings are same. The prompt is hyper-realistic portrait of a young woman with curly hair, soft sunlight falling on her face, realistic skin texture, natural makeup, subtle depth of field, cinematic lighting, 8K resolution, professional photography style. In background, realistic Amazon rainforest. Okay, let's hit the run button. Let's generate one more image. The prompt is a hyper-realistic miniature panda sitting on the tip of a human finger. Its soft black and white fur meticulously detailed. The panda appears playful, holding a tiny bamboo shoot in its paws. The background is softly blurred, with a natural green tone evoking the feel of a bamboo forest. The scene is brightly lit, showcasing the panda's lifelike fur texture and the delicate lines on the fingertip. Photographed with a macro lens, 8K ultra-high resolution, professional lighting, and fine detail. Okay, let's hit the run button. Here I am using Hunyuan Image Refiner version 2 GGUF model and rest all the model setting as previous one. VAE model for refiner is different, so choose the right one. I have selected this image to refine. We don't need first black cache here, so put 0. This positive prompt and negative prompt I have taken from official ComfyU workflow. Many thanks to the original creator. I'm keeping noise augmentation value to default 0.110. You can do experiment with it. I have selected only 4 steps. CFG is 1.0. Sampler is DPMPP2S Ancestral. Scheduler is Gale Optimal. And the denoise is 1.0. Okay, let's hit the run button. I hope you find this tutorial helpful. Please comment your opinion in the comment section below. If you like my effort, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel. Meet you in the next video.